Please get ready for transcription number 145. 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Chairman, I wish to support this bill, not because this is really a measure which will improve the conditions under which these institutions have come into existence in our country, but because I feel even a small thing like this, which will regulate the running of these homes, might do some temporary good. If we examine the reasons why these homes have come into existence, we will find that it is really a reflection on the social backwardness, because women are not educated, because women do not have the right to own property. Naturally, they are deserted, neglected, and are driven by the necessity of going into these homes run by the men in our society. These people run these homes under the guise of public charity, but these homes have really become centers of immoral traffic in our cities. These institutions are not only not run by the state as they should be, but they are run by religious and semi-religious bodies, by the so-called public-spirited men in our country. And as has been pointed out just now, it is stated in the report of the committee appointed by the Ministry of Welfare that they are even being financed by state funds and grants made by the Ministry of Welfare are used by such institutions for unethical purposes. I do not know how we will be able to control them by passing a bill like this, which will give them some kind of supervision by the state. Sir, I was personally connected with an institution in Uttar Pradesh, and it was an institution which was run under the name of Mahila Ashram, and the entire committee in control of that Mahila Ashram consisted of some of the lawyers and doctors of the capital of Uttar Pradesh. The means by which they secured the finance to run this institution will prove on what basis this institution is running. For every month that an inmate spends in that home, the prospective husband will have to pay at the rate of so many rupees per month. The only idea of this institution is to get the inmates married, and once they are married, they do not keep a record of the marriage. They do not keep any record of what happens to the inmates after marriage. Everybody knows that they are taken to other provinces by the operating gangs. Sir, one of the institutions quoted in that report is worth mentioning here. The committee went to Gaya in Bihar and they found that these women were practically locked up as if they were prisoners in that house, and then they were asked as to how many of them would like to stay there. 12 out of the 16 ran out of the house. This is typical not of a few but of the majority of the houses run under the name of women's homes or under the grand name of Mahila Ashrams. Only the other day in the Times of India, we read about a children's home run in Delhi with the financial aid of the Ministry of Welfare. Just to give a grant to an institution because it bears the name of women and children, even when it is supervised by a visiting committee or visiting men, does not really mean that we are solving the problem. Money can be wasted. In fact, in our country, lakhs and lakhs of rupees are wasted by giving indiscriminate grants to institutions which are either run by semi-religious or semi-social welfare bodies. And I think the government, if not private members, should bring forward a bill which would be for the abolition or total suppression of these homes. The only way to suppress the mishandling of this problem is to suppress the homes. Another thing I want to point out is that these homes flourish in a large way in those areas where social customs have militated against women. We don't find these homes flourishing with such popularity or in such large numbers in other parts of India, say in Maharashtra or Madhya Pradesh or in the south, where women have a good deal of freedom and educational opportunities. Stop.